The next step is actually gaining access to the interior of the eye. To do that, we're going to use scissors and we're going to make a transverse incision along the outside of the eye. If you have blunt scissors or just having trouble getting the incision started, you can use the scalpel. First, carefully press into the sclera to make a very small initial incision. Then all you need to do is make a series of short cutting movements to widen that incision just enough to allow your scissors to get under the sclera. As you move around the eye with the scissors and the incision gets larger, you will begin to expose the vitreous humor and a little bit of preservative fluid that may be remaining inside the eye. Before you cut completely around the eye, stop and open up your incision and examine the internal anatomy of the eye for the first time. You'll notice that the vitreous humor, which is a little bit thicker due to the preservative, should stay attached to the lens side of the eye. You'll also be able to observe the flexible nature of the sclera, or the outside wall of the eye. This is also a good opportunity to observe the retina in its completely intact form before we progress farther in the dissection. Now you can finish the incision you started to gain access to the eye. And once that's complete, we can begin removing the vitreous humor from around the lens and iris. To do this, you can carefully use your blunt probe to loosen the connection between the vitreous humor and the rest of the eye. Some portions of the vitreous humor may still remain in the eye, but at this point you should be able to clearly identify the lens and a dark ring surrounding it, which is the iris. Using your blunt probe, similar to how you remove the vitreous humor, you're going to want to loosen the lens from the body of the eye. It's held in place by a series of very small fibers which may or may not be visible. At this point, you'll also be able to expose the cornea, which may be cloudy due to the preservative. As you work on removing the lens, you'll note that it has a yellowish, cloudy color. This is an artifact of the preservation process and is normal in a preserved eye. After removing the lens and placing it on your work surface, you can investigate it in more detail. Take note of its shape and also its texture. It should feel rubbery and somewhat hard. This is yet another artifact of the preservation process, and it does not occur naturally in the eye. With the lens removed, we can now move on to examining the iris.